Welcome to the Pembroke Conservation Commission meeting. There's a couple of video cameras there, so one from PAC TV and one from Pembroke Town News. So just so everyone knows, you're being recorded, and some members also have recording devices. Our first item on the agenda is an RDA for 38 Alvern Ave. Is there anyone here for that? 38 Alvern Ave. Mary, do you have any anything for that? This is Lally. So she should be here. Okay. Hello.
Hi.
Do you want me to call her? She's going to be very upset if she is.
We got a couple other things we can. And I let's postpone it a little bit, see if she's.
Okay, put that off until later.
She's been waiting 3 or 4 weeks for this.
Yeah, do you want me to give her a call?
Yeah, why don't you?
Yeah, why don't you see if she's.
I'm sure she's okay.
Our next time is at 7:40, so Bob, did you have something?
Yep, I want you to hold everything until we make the phone call.
Please.
Yeah, you can try those.
Excuse me, sir.
We have a request for an extension on an order of conditions for the treatment of algae and so forth in Oldham Pond. And I move that we extend it to May 19th, 2020. Second.
So, and who was that from? Who's making that request?
Treasurer of Water Quality, Chairman Pembroke Watershed Association.
Okay. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. We'll have to tell Mary about that. Yes. I know that group's been doing a lot of work with the algae and stuff, so. They did?
Oh, really?
Yeah. They treated Oldham Pond?
Yep.
And how about Furnace?
Nope, just those.
Okay.
Makes a world of difference when you do that and stuff gets out of control in the summer.
And the lily pads are like this big.
Oh, man, they just turn green and gross.
There's also a request to extend the DOA for Oldham Village Beach. Do you know what that is, Bob?
What?
The Oldham Village Beach.
That's what I'm trying to figure out. What, right? This is a, I have it right in front of me here, and I'm trying to see what.
But we won't put pump the residents take care of that thing.
Yeah, it's just, this is just a request to file extension permit. Okay, let's, I move that we extend the determination of applicability at 41 Adams Ave Beach for another 3 years. This just allows them to do work on the beach. None of these extensions, they can do anything in the water. It's always just beach nourishment. Mm-hmm.
And are you looking at what they're doing as they're working?
Oh, yeah, on top of them all.
They've done a great job down there cleaning that up. They did a great job.
Yeah, they clean them up, pull the weeds off, and if there's any rocks still, it might bring in a little bit of sand, but never very much.
Okay.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Okay. We also have a request to use Tubbs Meadow on July 11th from 4:30 to 7:30 for a Cub Scout Pack 105 Catch and Release Fishing Derby.
On that one, I see no problems other than we got to know whether they're going to want cooking fires or not, and whether or not we are going with no barbed hooks or Rich has been very strong on no barbed hooks, but some of these reservoirs, the remaining fish don't have a whole lot left.
Lips left.
They've all been caught so many times.
Put back so many times over a year.
I would say that we prefer the use of barbless hooks, or at least crush the barbs. I definitely agree with that part of it, but the Cub Scouts, you know, the part of it's just hanging out catching sunfish all day, well, maybe a bass, you know.
Can we put that into the, what is it that we give to them, the permission?
I would prefer the use of barbless hooks, but maybe not mandate it in this particular case.
I could suggest that they use barbless hooks.
Tournaments.
Right, no doubt. Cub Scouts, I mean, that's, let's face it, you know, it's hanging out bailing sunfish all day is what life's about.
Sunfish are what we're going to see a lot anyway.
Right, right, you know, we would prefer, so.
And I think we want to make sure we say something about fire, Mary.
Yes, that they need to contact the fire department for fire, and that we were recommending the use of barbless hooks.
We're requesting the use of barbless hooks, or hooks with crushed barbs or filed down, however they want to do it, yep. Plus, it makes it a whole lot easier to pull them out of the kids' arms. Coming from a guy who's impaled himself 20 times, I know what it's like.
They make, let us know the day before, we can make sure the gates are, no, we don't want them driving in other than emergency vehicle or something like that.
Right.
The gate should be at least open.
Okay, so do we need a vote for that?
I'll make the motion that we do grant permission and insert the requests of the board in order to have the Cub Scouts use Tubbs Meadow for a catch and release fishing derby.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Unanimous. Mary, while you were out of the room, we also had unanimous votes on the first two items.
Too early.
Okay. And so what did you find there, Rick?
Wild oysters in all different states. They haven't started to see yet hard, so.
Oh, don't be too happy.
Yeah. Is she going to come tonight, or no? All right, so what, would you continue that item?
Well, we can, let me, Alex, I'll tell you what, all it is another beach and nourishment request, only this is a new one. They live on, actually live on the pond at off of Elvin Road, and Scott went up there and looked at it and all. It just needs a little sand to replace some of the washout that's been there. And I see no reason not to grant it.
So, do we want to grant that now? Should we?
Yeah. Okay.
I make the motion to grant the Valley family off of Alvern Road the right to add some sand. They have it's a washout by their retaining wall, and they just want to fill in what's been washed into the water.
Okay, do we have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay.
That brings us to an RDA for 138 Oldham Street. Mr. Ehrenberg.
No, Mr. McGowan here.
Mr. McGowan. How you doing?
Good. So, so this is 138 Oldham Street, and they are having problems with their septic system and they need to upgrade. We are proposing to put in 1,500 gallon tank and a 16 by 26 leaching bed that will be 80 feet away from the closest spot of well. There are no variances that we asked for from the Board of Health, and that's been approved by them.
Okay.
What do we have for a siltation?
What you have right here is red line above.
hay bale line.
Yep.
Hay bale or...
Yeah, I use the silt saw.
Okay. And you're gonna do wood chips on the up one side of it?
Honestly, the boys are gonna put this in cement so fast that the grass has been grown before.
Yeah, they did.
Yeah.
Best possible for the rock.
Yep.
Ooh, close.
I'll second. Okay, oh, sorry.
Yeah, on favor?
Aye. I move reissue a... Move reissue a negative three with a normal boilerplate.
I'll second.
I don't know if we ever use a boilerplate, it's what we call our standard set of rules or regulations that go with everything else.
Do you have a second?
I'll second that.
Is this a site that needs to have the stuff loaded onto a truck or is it going to do...
Should be enough room on that lot to be able to start by what they need to.
Yeah.
Just the, sometimes.
Okay, so, on favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
That was an easy one. Thank you.
Thank you.
That took 2 minutes. Okay, the next thing is at 7:50, so we have a few minutes for discussion. Does anyone have any business? What's it, 234 and 242 Valley Street? Do we have anything new about that?
No, that's the court case where the ball is in their hand as to, it appeared as if they filed at the court. Now it's just how the court proceeds and all that. The longer the better. Like 15 or 20 years would be nice.
So do we need to keep that on our ongoing business every week?
That way if something comes in, we can, it makes it so we can talk about it.
Okay.
It looks good, like we're doing something.
Yeah, we don't do enough as it is.
It's just continued.
It says DEP file number about the Route 53 project, and that's our next notice of intent. What, Mary, what's that? Administrative business?
I think that's just that we got a number.
On stormwater pollution prevention plan for the national.
Well, it's the one before that.
They give file numbers. It's in the mail folder.
Okay.
All this stuff is in the mail folder. I just wanted to know what the.
Well, you can go ahead and tell me that one then, because I was going to ask you.
Okay. Stormwater pollution prevention plan.
That's what
I'm talking about. National pollution. Discharge elimination system.
Oh, very good.
For the Massachusetts construction general permit. And that is...
I
don't have it with me. It's rather thick. If you want to look at it, it's in the blue 14 file.
Okay.
I would suggest if anyone really wants to look at it, they look at that one copy because it would take half a ream of paper just to recopy what's there. And most of it is something that, unless you're an engineer, isn't going to make any sense to you at all.
Have you been able to look it over?
Hell yeah, I carried it around and
flipped it. It all looks good.
People were a whole lot smarter than me who put it together, and it's just one of the requirements for all these projects.
Yeah, for the tanks that they're putting in and all the runoff control.
Okay. There's a notice of appeal about the water wheel amended. What was he? Can you tell me what that is? You don't know?
Is it in the
mail folder? Where is the mail folder? Here it is.
This appeal, notice of appeal is fairly lengthy. As I start and I started reading it, I surely haven't read it all or even begin to fathom what what it says. I think that we're probably going to need copies of it, Mary, for people to take and read and understand before we really start.
And this was filed by Mr. Kerry Day, former Conservation Commissioner himself. Yeah. He's got the number of signatures.
Now, did somebody take that amended order of conditions last week? It wasn't in the file folder.
It was submitted to the selectman's office.
Okay, who took it?
I took it. I gave it to the selectman's office. No, I didn't. We can get one.
Yeah, we need a copy of these.
Yeah, we're going to need copies of this, too.
It's just something we can take a look at. We'll have to continue that to our next meeting. And
yeah, I think so. So you hear blatant misconduct.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay, so, Mary, could we get a copy of this, please? Got 4 minutes until our next I didn't sign this yet. No. I'll do it. If Mary wants it. I have something here.
The mail folder's still right here, that way. There's only two that are.
I think they're right there, Mary.
Yeah, we pass these down to be signed. Everybody's just going to sign them and pass those down.
These are the ones we signed.
Oh, really?
Oh, good.
So is there anything we need to especially watch out for on that to make sure?
It's really not that we have to. In other words, it's all up in the upland. Our concern is what's going to come out of it after it's done.
Right.
What's coming out of it now has done what it's done. And until they get it, so something is different. You know, we're watching it all the time, but you know, it's nothing that's in our jurisdiction.
Okay. So we have to wait until it's done to see if there's a problem with it?
Yeah. No. And then we kind of figure if anyone's going to complain about undoing what was done before. In other words, this project doesn't undo what was already done.
It's already been cut through those swaths that have passed.
But at the same time, there's no sense trying to fix any of that until we see what the new one does.
Right.
You're still going to get rid of the water one way or the other.
Right. And they're aware of the problem that's there now, right? So
oh, yeah.
People are aware of it, but don't want to be aware of it.
Okay, so it's just about 7:50, so we've noticed some intent for Route 53 at Thorne. DEP file number SE56-965. Is Ed Thorne going to come in here for a meeting, or...?
probably hung up next door still.
Yeah. I don't know.
They're still working, actually.
Yeah.
Should we maybe continue this for a few minutes?
Yeah, we should just continue it.
Okay. Excuse me.
Do we get the people in there to it?
The engineers out there.
Yeah, but I think we want, Mr. Thorne is that we don't want to get into another one of those people not here when.
Correct.
When they should be.
Right.
I mean, if we get 8 o'clock, then I say go on with the other ones and wait for them.
Okay. Gotta wait a few minutes. The selectmen are running late, I guess.
Wait for that phone, yeah. He's a proponent.
Mattakee's at Ballfields, is that the same as the 234 Valley Street? We're just holding that for discussion, or is there something?
Holding that for trees or something, where was it?
Yeah. I've had a number of suggestions from different people about the Ballfield trees. I'm still in the feeling that we should get them from the Recreation Commission. They've specifically stated that we should get trees from them. We've also have a number of other ways to get trees, so it's not a big deal, but you know, they should come up with the trees because they took them down.
Do they have a non-profit number that they work with that we could do a grant for matching funds?
I honestly don't know, Ray.
Because that's another way that we used to get more.
Well, do we have a non-profit number with the Conservation Commission?
We have taxes downstairs and the ice cream.
Okay.
We're going for grants. That's from the outside of this agency.
Is it? Yeah, we just have to apply for it. Something like $15,000, something we can get from
up to 30,000.
Up to 30?
They have incorporated everything that they want to see on these things that can cover the community. Outside of the community, we had in the village there. Very exclusive line, brought a bus down. So as far as reaching out and enriching the community and doing forestry, there's a good grant for that.
Some of these grants are going to require the open space thing to be in existence, and ours is not up to date at the present time, and that's another thing that's being worked on by the Open Space Committee. But
these are all different projects and new projects.
Most of them require the open space, you know, that the town has their open space program in line before they'll accept any of the grants.
This is from an electric company, so it's private. It's not as much like the government stuff. We'll figure it out.
National Grid?
Yeah.
They were always good. Years ago.
They've got some great stuff out there.
Replacing trees.
You know?
National Grid did work.
They did a big cleanup. But one of four.
Well,
they
did last year, yeah.
Six trees, I think.
I also wanted to see, does anybody have any feedback about Sharon Rick's presentation last week and how we can move forward with that project at the Herring Run?
Well, I was impressed with Sharon's work. Thank you for it. I think we need to incorporate that, and perhaps maybe we want to make Sharon in charge of that section of it. But the engineers for Herring Run Park have been saying, we want to know what you want. And they've kind of been saying, what do you think we should have? So I think maybe we should let Sharon be our in-between between the engineers and the board as to our ideas of what we might like to see there. so that they can draw plans that then we can look at a closer, to make sure it's, you know, more like what we have. There's been one of the, we want you to tell us, no, you tell us type of thing. We need someone to get in and say, okay, here's the gauntlet, we're throwing the gauntlet down to you with this to start with. Now, what can you do with this in the, you know, from the engineering standpoint?
I need like your input, that way I can do a little bit more, and then when they say, okay, what do they want from us?
That's why I think I'd like to have you. You did such a good job. Why don't you head that part? We'll all give you all, you can tell, we'll give you all the information you want. As long as you have a little bit of time.
We're up here digging on that site. If it is a heritage site, is that heritage site?
Yes, these are problems that the engineer, we're across the engineer.
That's why I'm asking.
We could get into all sorts of things in the future there. We don't know, because it could easily be an dig site.
I would have a no dig policy then, and leave the footprint instead of putting posts in the ground to have seats, just the round pieces of wood.
This is what we need the engineers for. Yeah. In other words, we want to tell them.
Goes on. Big pools around the big rocks and pools, they are on top of things. Like, don't dig at all.
Well, like if you have the seating, it's a concrete seating, you don't have to dig for that. They can just make a seat or whatever and just set it on the ground. Nobody's going to sit up and take off with it. So, I mean, it's really desperate to move that rock.
I'm not going to get any far. We'll find it in the brook.
Rich, this is what we really need, though, is a plan that shows these things. We don't want you digging here. So if the engineer said we're digging 18 holes at 2 foot deep, we're saying, no, you've got to come up with a better idea, because we don't want to take the chance that after the first shovelful we come up with Indian bows and arrowheads, and they're going to shut the whole project down for
a few minutes. You can't dig up there without getting shards. You can't take a shovel of dirt out of there without getting white shards in it. That's why I say just put it on top. Just put everything on top.
It would appear the selectmen may be ready for us. Well, we're ready for the selectmen, I'm sure.
I think Ed just walked out.
You want to chase him there? We're going to go chase him.
You're probably faster than him.
Looked like he was headed out the main door, Mary. He might be running off his car for a minute. He's been here since 8:30 this morning.
We don't usually get this backed up, but be patient, we'll be with you in a few minutes. Not that we know of. I looked for that, and I didn't really know what I was looking at either.
Neither did I. I expected it to come. $7.59.
So this is going back to the 7:50.
Yeah. Are we ready for?
I think we are.
Yeah.
Come on in. Hello. Your name's on it. That's what we thought you. So notice of intent for the Route 53 project, DEP file number SE56-965.
State road, I stopped at 14.
That's a way to flush it.
Yeah, probably over there. Hello.
Hi.
Thanks for coming in.
You're welcome. Should I begin or?
Please.
Okay, great. All right, thank you. My name is John Morgan. I'm here with Associate James Hall. We're here for the 53 Pleasant Street intersection project. Filing a notice of intent. The town of Pembroke is the opponent of this project. Ed Thorne representing the Board of Selectmen. They are the proponent applicant. We are their representatives from CHA Consulting. We are the designers of the project. And the project will be constructed by MassDOT, funding to the state, and they will be responsible for construction administration of the project. So, the project involves intersection improvements at the intersection of Pleasant Street, and this is Route 53 Washington Street, and the total project limits are approximately 1,400 feet along Washington Street, and that begins about 400 feet north of Water Street and extends south to about 400 feet south of Pleasant Street, and that is just north of Pudding Brook. We are within the riverfront buffers of Pudding Brook. So, the proposed improvements involve signalizing the intersection of Pleasant Street and Route 53. The intersection associated with that signalization will be the addition of some turn lanes, a left turn lane in the southbound direction, the left turn lane onto Pleasant Street, and a right turn lane in the northbound direction, so it will be a right turn lane on Pleasant Street as well. And the purpose of the project is to improve both safety, the high accident location, and capacity. It's very difficult to make a left turn out of Pleasant Street with long delays and queues. Part of the project will be making pedestrian and bicycle improvements as required by MassDOT. We're required to meet all of their standards. Washington Street Route 53 is a state highway, so it is their roadway. Pleasant Street and Water Street, the work that we're doing on those roadways are in the town of Pembroke jurisdiction. So we will be putting in a minimum 5-foot paved shoulders for bicycles on both sides of Washington Street along the project limits. So that is the minimum width for bicycles. And we're also adding sidewalks on both sides of Washington Street between Pleasant Street and Water Street, where they do not exist today, connecting to the existing sidewalk north of Water Street. And on the west side of Washington Street, it will end at the condominium development driveway. So the project will be resurfacing, milling and overlaying the existing pavement. Where we're widening, we'll be putting in new full depth pavement, new gravel, base course, binder course, top course. There'll be all new signs and pavement markings along the project. And then there will be drainage improvements as part of this project. Existing drains. Drainage does not meet the current standards. We're also, because we're widening, we have new basins with the gutter lines. So we have a total of 14 new deep sump catch basins, 4-foot minimum sump, spaced at a minimum of 300 feet apart per MassDOT standards. We will be adding approximately a little under half an acre of impervious area as part of this project with the widening of sidewalks and turn lanes. So we will be adding flow. So we will be increasing the size of a couple of existing pipes within the project limits in order to accommodate the increase in flow. And there is an existing outlet just north of Pudding Brook. And we'll be replacing the pipe coming to that outlet, the flared end. We'll be replacing that flared end, and there is erosion in that area. So we will be we're proposing to put stone at the pipe ends, to help prevent future erosion. So that's essentially what we're looking to do. I have Jay can talk a little bit about the resource areas in this area. Ready, Jay?
I am ready. I'll try to make this brief. If there are any questions, please ask him. Whatever you do. I'm trying to get back on track. I forget where I was. Somewhere in here, I have a plan set of all sorts of tree colors.
You're cheap old, aren't you?
So, as John mentioned, go back real quick. Most of our impacts here are associated with Pudding Brook and riverfront area buffer zones. There's some wetlands in this area here as well, and then there's a FEMA flood zone. That correlates to Pudding Brook is the bank that was delineated is in blue. We've got wetland resources here and here. This is actually an old road. I suspect the wetlands were combined at one point. You've got the 100-foot riverfront area inner, 200-foot riverfront area outer. The 100-foot riverfront area is also a 100-foot buffer to the bank because there are no wetlands here. You can see the buffer zones from the bank. And the length is 100-foot, or 100-year floodplain. It's elevation 8. So basically, all the work that's happening is mostly a result of flood, improvements to the flood system, the drainage system. There's about 6 square feet of BDW wetland impacts here. There's actually just a culvert that has to be dug out a little bit because the water's not really draining well through here. I want to make sure that gets out here so this area doesn't get flooded. So that's about 6 square feet. We're going to replicate it here with about 12 square feet. In kind, basically, there's northern arrowwood and silky dogwood and hybrid blueberries, so that'll be just a small area impact there when they dig out that area. And as John mentioned, there's going to be about 6 linear feet of impact to the bank, or in this particular case, what happened is the existing 12-inch pipe that's in here, they eventually will be slowly getting a head cut, kind of creeping up away from the bank. So the idea is to, when the 12-18-inch pipe is going to replace the 12-inch pipe, we're going to basically put an additional amount of rock in this area up to the edge of the bank, just so that we don't continue to have that erosion. This also happens to be within the reporting lines of the flooding. That rock dissipator is going to actually be placed at grade, so there's going to be no extra fill. It's just going to fill up what is currently eroding because of the head cut. And that's about 486 square feet. And then basically the work in the riverfront area, there's about 7,100 square feet of impact on the riverfront area itself. Of this, most of it's temporary. There's only going to be 235 new riverfront area impervious impact, 99 square feet in the inner, and 136 square feet in the outer. The rest is all temporary. And at least half of that, 7,100 square feet, about 3,600 square feet, is actually the road itself. So really not a lot of impact at all. One of the other items that we identified while we were here, there's actually habitat for a teeny species of natural heritage. Similar to report 14 that was done down in this area way back when, we have the eastern box turtle, the eastern, tidewater market. So the eastern pond mussel and the tidewater mussel are the three species. I was in touch with Lauren Glorioso today at Natural Heritage. They're probably not going to get the response letter out, but they don't anticipate because we're really not doing any work in the banks and very little work outside of the banks. This is going to be an impact to those species. This is a limited project, and so work in the riverfront area is allowed as long as we improve things. But again, that's kind of your decision, not ours. And so the idea is that by improving a lot of the infrastructure here in terms of putting curbing and deep stone catch basin will improve water quality here, as well as get this area stabilized and not have erosion into putting growth. So some of the consideration for riverfront area alternative analysis was no build. But then they're not going to have the pedestrian and vehicular safety. There's apparently no sidewalk between Water Street and Pleasant Street, Water Street. Basically, so if nothing happens, we're still going to have the problems that are going on today. So then some other ideas were, can we reduce scope? One of the questions was, can we just work on the road improvements and not do any storm drainage? However, as we're putting new pavement, there's going to be more discharge of overland flow, and you've got two small closed drainage systems up in this area, up in here. And the problem is that if there isn't improvements to the stormwater drainage, you're going to get potentially flooding and more issues with the water quality as well, whatever comes off the road and down this area. And this pipe, this 12-inch pipe, certainly isn't sized for greater flows. Another option was to try to maybe put in a stormwater feature like the detention basin. There is very little public area here, and you'd have to require acquisition of private landowners, and that's going to be a cost. So the idea was, can we put in a stormwater system? And apparently the soils are C's and D's, so there's very little infiltration as well. So it would just be a retention basin, not a detention basin. So that said, the idea is that getting the stormwater improve the intersection themselves, improve the outflow here to clean up a little bit of the water quality in this area, get this working so you're not flooding this area out.
Is this would appear kind of possible that we're selling off a little bit of conservation input for a project? In other words, the drainage is better, but not the best. Fair statement.
Yeah.
All right. I just want to make sure we get to that we're basically not getting all that we would like to get, or all that maybe we should get, but we're getting more than what we have now.
Right.
Plus a project one.
And ultimately, it's going to be, at a minimum, it's going to be improvements in the water quality discharge, at least on the catch basins, making sure that head cut. Banks are putting Brook stabilized. And it's not a big area, it's high
flow. And it's mostly because of cost, because we don't have any place to work in there. We have to go out and take land and make the drainage better.
Exactly.
I just want to make sure we have that in for future. And the second part, I know the answer, but I'm going to wait. This project is not going to tie into the Route 14 project, is that correct? In other words, our sidewalks are going to end one spot and another spot, and we have an area in between without sidewalks or bicycle lane or anything else. I just want that in the record that we've been through this.
Yes, unfortunately, the scope of the project limited to intersection improvements, and to extend the project all the way down to the Route 14 intersection was outside the scope of what the DOT was willing to pay for as part of this project.
Now, isn't there land owned by Mass DOT?
Mass DOT owns the roadway.
And then isn't there a parcel of land north of Putting Brook on the right-hand side that's owned
by Mass DOT? Yeah, they own a drainage piece on this.
We're right to the left of that vacant lot, Chipko's property. There's
a fenced-in area.
There's a fenced-in area that I believe belongs to the state.
Right
in there.
It would be worth looking into because that's a pretty major piece that's not connected.
Towards the old watch back.
unfortunately,
yeah, that comes out of the road.
Yeah.
If you're and talking, that was put in when they did the drainage at the intersection of 14 and 53, 10 or 12 years ago. They put all that drainage in and redid that as the piece they got at the time for their detention.
So is that this area here, you think? I know this kind of old road is basically broken up this piece, but
it's got,
is it
got chain link fence?
It's got chain link. It's got chain, it's got chain link fence all the way around. Okay.
Up at the other end, there's a housing project across from Water Street there. There's a septic system that's fairly close to Route 53. How close are you going to come to that with your construction? Is it at the northern point of the blue line there?
At the northern limit up here, all of our work is within the state highway layout, so we're adding a sidewalk basically here, but our edge of pavement is pretty much where it is existing, so we're going about 5 feet up.
And so that's all currently the state property? And you're not going to be taking any property from there?
No, we can take this here for construction. I believe there may be a temporary or there may be an overhead easement that starts in here that's for overhead utility lines, but that's a thing on the ground.
Okay.
Construction.
I have no additional problems with the project. We haven't already talked about it.
Do we have any comments from the public?
I just have one question. The three of us are trustees at Pembroke condominiums.
Okay.
So this is not going to affect our leaching field at all in the front, the drainage that's going in. And we're lay people, so bear with us.
Right.
Where's the vent close to that northern area that you were talking about? For the leaching field? So from the road, we were wondering how far you were going to come in because there's a venting system there.
Our work will be about 5 to 6 feet in the edge of pavement. Just adding a sidewalk along this section of road. The roadway won't be widening in that area. So we will be relocating some of the utility poles back a little bit, but behind the sidewalk that we will give them. All of that work is well within the state highway layout, so.
And the drainage wouldn't affect our leaching field again. I don't know how the drainage is going to be set up.
Okay. No, there's an existing head wall with the drainage outlets right in front of the condominiums.
Head wall.
It's a small concrete outlet point where the pipe comes out. And that area there will remain the same so that where the water is coming out from the drainage will continue to follow the same location.
So you're not taking any of our land?
What about on the other side of the driveway?
On the north side?
No, yep, south side.
South side of the driveway? Yeah, that's what I was looking at here. I can check the design plans to see if we have any. I think there might be an easement needed for utility lines.
There's a fire hydrant right there.
Construction will take 9 months estimated. Right now, the project is scheduled to be advertised in April of 2017. Construction will start probably
like late 1990 something.
April of 2017. So maybe
summer
of 2017 or fall of 2017 if they might get started.
I'll be dead by the time it gets
spring, 2018.
question, why are you checking on that one? The other concern is this is not going to put us in violation of any Title V requirements. Because you're not taking any money. That's our only concern.
What about the traffic coming out of Water Street to take a left? They have a lot. Most traffic comes out of Pleasant and Water Street to take the left. So how is the light of Pleasant going to help traffic coming out of Water Street to take a left and then impact on us getting out of the driveway?
The traffic light will create some gaps in the northbound direction because people will have to stop coming northbound. So basically,
at 5 o'clock at night,
at different times, you know, every all day long, there'll be times where the Pleasant Street,
yeah,
where Washington Street, the light turns red, so the northbound traffic will have to stop, and you may notice that there'll be a gap in the northbound traffic at Water Street or at the condominiums, which could help you.
Our concern is if they stop at Pleasant Street,
yeah,
it's going to back it up to the point where people trying to take a left out of Water Street won't be able to do it.
That's why Pleasant Street can't get out, because people from Water Street can back up over people on Pleasant Street picking the left.
Right.
So you're just creating another problem.
Maybe time the signals so that they will minimize those queues in the peak hour periods, so the chance that the traffic will back up beyond Water Street will be slim. It won't happen very often.
We'll trust you on that.
It does.
Just give us your name and home
address. If we don't have anything else,
thank you.
Okay, so we're going to continue it.
Okay.
Thank you. Till we hear from who? Oh, okay.
We filed with NACSP already. We did, and I, if you want, I can give you Lauren Gordios' number.
Yeah,
what's that?
I was just looking at the letter.
We have an LOP I can send you as well.
Any of the green guys not the
Yes, there's always some. I actually don't know which ones. I'm just saying off the top of my head, we never get all the green cards back, which is why we keep the green and white cards shortly submitted the notification there. I think there's maybe been one or two projects where there was that green, all we get all the green white cards back. Some of them actually come back with letter and open because the assessor's office is always hard to get one place.
We are sorting, and what did endangered species really say? That they looked for a problem or there wasn't a problem?
There is identified habitat for pond mussel, the tidewater mucket, and the box turtle. Because there's very little work off the side of the road and very little work on the bank of the river itself, there's going to be very little impact actually the stream, putting brook. And the actually improvement by stabilizing the head cut is also improving the water quality as well.
Is there anything else that we can do to improve that? The habitat for those species within this project?
The idea is that, I mean, they can try to, I can't find this, I'll have to check and see if we have another one. That's certainly, I can check and see if it was, it may have been sent by FedEx. So I'll follow up on that one. And or I can have you stay in touch with it. One of the options, which would be nice, is to get a saw solution versus the prep. It's only 6 linear feet, so about my height of rock, which is going to be a very small area for the stream itself. I prefer being able to plant willows and various herbaceous species like northern arrowwood or, or various carrot species in there. The problem is because you have a 12-inch, currently a 12-inch pipe that's discharged in that area, and now you're going to have an 18-inch pipe. The idea is we really want to stabilize that, and it takes a while for the root system to grow, even with willow species, which grow pretty quickly. So just for that small area, it's just better to stabilize it that way instead of putting in something and after you get your first big 2-inch rainfall in an hour, have the whole thing wash out. So just one of those things that it's kind of the better solution, and it is a small area. It's not like hundreds of feet long. It's better for the environment. Over time, actually, you can often get get some sediment going in that area, and often get those areas to naturally vegetate native species anyway. We'll actually fill in all the rock areas of the town. So, the idea is just at least to keep from the slow erosion of the material.
So, at least it keeps the land there instead of downstream somewhere.
This is covered in the plans now. Back to the National Heritage. Now, what are we expecting from National Heritage?
We're expecting a response letter. And she told me over the phone that the review isn't completed, but she doesn't anticipate any impacts to habitat or species.
Oh, all right. Because if you're expecting a letter that says there is no problem, we perhaps can close with the assumption that the letter will say that. Or we'll have to continue and wait for the letter. What do you feel? I mean, those are really the two options that we have.
Well, I don't anticipate a problem, but if we close and she ends up saying, we need to have you do this, this, and this,
that's what I say,
then we have to re-notify. So it might be safer to wait till we get the letter, ensure that there is no impact to species and habitat, and then come in to open up so then it can be closed at that point.
I move that we continue the hearing till June 22nd.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thanks for coming in. Okay, a little bit behind schedule now, but are we on the 8 o'clock?
Yes, well.
Continuation of the notice of intent for 41 to 49. I'm sorry. Okay, yeah, we could do that.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to skip over that one for a second. And move to the 8:10 p.m. continuation of RDA for 91 Phillips Road. Hello.
Hi.
How you doing? Piece of road that you can see both the ponds on each side of it. Far away from the ponds as it could be.
Yeah, well, the water supply here is just outside that 100.
I don't see any siltation there.
I don't have any shown on there at this point.
Nothing's going on that side of the road?
Nope, no. The plan is to try to keep it
on this side. All right. Then we need a flotation barrier. Probably going to have to come back to here, so probably from the corner of your house here and something to curve on that side.
Okay.
I haven't had a chance to really look. Is this a remove replace or?
It's removal of the existing.
Yeah, that's not, but not digging a big hole and filling it with sand right now. In other words, you're not going to be stockpiling a lot of material.
No, when I talked to the Paul Town Act, actually, he talked about, lower than go on the wall. Stuff directly into the truck.
Yeah.
So it'll be on no on-site storage, huh?
When I first talked to him, that was the plan. Because I was saying, we could probably use the basketball court across the street, but he's, I have to get into that.
So we need the siltation shown on the map.
Yeah, well, we need siltation shown from the corners. Was it northeast of course? Okay, north. From the northwest corner of the house to the fence, and from the northeast corner of the house to the upper edge of the road. I'm saying the upper edge of the road. If he wants more work, that's all right, but in other words, something from the house up to this corner.
Do you have a preference to hay bales or what they're using?
Either silt, 12-inch silt sock or double-stake hay bales with chips on the upper side. And these will have to all be checked by the agent before work begins.
Okay.
I think that's all I have. Somebody else has anything else they've seen?
No, looks all right to me. So nowhere else you can put it.
So you're the civil engineer and the property owner?
I am.
This is Holden? Yeah. That's Furnace, and that's Big Sandy.
Big Sandy, okay.
That picture we have is right there.
So we're going to continue this until we get the updated drawing, or?
No, we can put that in on the
perfect. Perfect. Are you going to put two on one side? Or?
Yeah, it's all right there on the side of the roof.
With the
sorry, but all the delays.
It's staying on the same side as the house.
Yeah.
This is so
anywhere,
beach, right?
These have to be checked before you
that's
can
the old beach.
Oh, yeah. So this is all land right here. And this is
that's
some
the beach.
Someone will be out there to look at it before anything.
Okay.
That's a beach across here.
Right over here.
Yeah. This whole layer is the beach.
So I'm going to close this.
Okay.
Close it. Add a filtration barrier. And water plate.
And water plate.
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Close an issue of -3.
Yeah.
Close an issue of -3. Can we have a second?
Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
We want to build according to plan with hay bales and siltation barrier.
Okay.
I haven't got a date for the contractor yet. I was going to call tomorrow. I'll get a date.
Yeah, if I could get
this going next week,
my wife
would
be happy.
Is that okay with
you
guys?
Yes, it
works
for us. Absolutely.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Yes. Do you want to send it?
Okay, now that the moment we've all been waiting for here. Continuation from last week. This is a continuation notice of intent for 41 to 49 Cross Street. DEP file number SC56-963.
Good evening. I'm Attorney Bob Galvin. I'm representing National Development. And I just wanted to bring you up to speed on our approval tonight across the way.
Okay.
So tonight, we did get our vote approving the project, subject to conditions. The conditions have actually been approved, but they're going to put them in writing and sign them on the 27th. A particular concern to the commission, I know, was the stormwater management system and its compliance with this, the stormwater management regulations. And Pete Palmieri, who's the planning board's peer review consultant, has approved the plan and indicated to the planning board tonight, and that's why they did vote to approve this. The project does comply with the stormwater management regulations in every respect. And I think he's going to actually add a note to his letter that confirms that, but the planning board relied upon that in approving the project tonight. So, if you want to add anything else.
I just got first glance at the, what do we call it, Mary? I just, you gave me that, the engineering.
Yeah,
from Merrill's. We hadn't seen anything until half an hour or less before the meeting. I haven't been able to digest it all. Not that I find anything wrong with it, I just need to be able to read it and look at it. And the same with the stormwater management plan, we haven't seen that. I'd like to take it and read it. You just said you aren't getting your approval for the 27th?
No, we're getting it tonight.
Midnight, but you're going to get signed papers on the 27th.
We will have it on the 27th.
If everything is in order for us to look at, we could have our signed papers for the 27th also without closing the night. I don't want to close till I read what's been said. I mean, that was what we said last week, but Merrill or whoever was going to give us a copy didn't give us anything until just before, and Mary had to go get it from somewhere else. So
they gave it to me. I didn't get it from the planning board. I got it from Sean.
Yeah. But it was tonight.
Yeah.
So yeah, there's more than I could do in 20 minutes to digest it all. Even though it looked fine, I still like to read it all. I don't have any problem with the project that I know about, but I just like to read the documents before we close in case there is a problem. But if you people are satisfied that we aren't going to have a problem, you know it better than we do, then we can have the paperwork all set and ready to go so that when we meet on the 27th, we can sign it and then we have it ready for it.
Yeah, it's the draft of the conditions.
Yes.
So, Bob, I have a question. Is it possible, because I'm kind of waiting to move on to another, take the horses to another farm, is it possible to get it done earlier than that, or is this status quo?
I find it hard in my mind to close without reading.
No, obviously, I can't.
And the next week we're not reading, so we can't do anything till the 27th. But I can pretty much assure you that, you know, it doesn't appear that anybody has a problem with it. And if planning board has looked it over and said there's no problem, and Merrill said there's no problem, then probably there is no problem. But I just like to make sure I have no problem before I say anything to them. Sometimes we've been able to jump the gun and then we get a hand slap later on. So
is this the case where we might want to have a meeting next week to take care of this?
No, I mean, if they're not going to get anything until the 27th.
Oh, they're not going to get it until the 27th.
The decision's all written.
Yeah.
They asked us to add 3 conditions. So we're writing that and then I'm going to give it back to them and I'll actually copy you all on them.
Right.
So you have that decision as
that's
well.
That's right. Something weird. And then Mary can have our papers ready and we can sign them that.
And then, although it might appear that, you know, when you vote on the 27th, in conjunction with them, who are all lined up, there is an appeal period for the notice of intent, which there isn't for our site plan approval. So even though you line up your vote, you still will have to wait another 10 days for you all, which before you can record. And so that's a little bit.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, but that's what we have to deal with. We have to be able to look it over before we vote on it.
Could the hearing be closed this evening?
Are we going to continue the hearing?
I don't think he wants to continue it because he's a red tape.
So we'll leave the hearing open and just continue it until the 27th?
That's what I would like. I mean, that's, you know, if people feel comfortable closing without reading the documents, that's...
I think it'd be a good idea to read them.
But I don't.
Yeah, I would obviously like to read them as well. And I'm also not object to coming in next week to sign them. That way they're in time frame. I mean, if it helps the project go, it's been held up through no fault of theirs. Or ours, right. None at all. I'm just saying, if that helps both parties,
it would help us immensely.
Right. I don't have an issue.
We have a real estate closing that's dependent on it, but we actually also want to get underway with our demolition delay because the house that's on there qualifies. So.
I have no problem meeting next week if we can get the documents so we all can read them. We'll make it a quick so we can
right.
Something.
Is that okay with all the other members? Or?
We get all the paperwork we need to look at.
We'll come in on our day off. They don't feel guilty looking, they're all laughing. It's all good. I just, you know, again, if we can get that done and we can all get copies ahead of time, we'll just come in and sign it.
We can salvage 7 of the 10 days.
Could we maybe just go through what you need and what we're going to provide just so we're clear? I don't want to show up next week and find out there's something missing. So we...
They need a copy of that draft decision, which I'll email Bob.
Okay. And so we have the... I provided one set of the revised plans, Mary, but do you need more sets of the revised plans?
We want...
I could do half size if that's a little more easier for everything. So. Okay. And then we had the original response to comments, which was back in early May. I can provide that with all the drainage updates and everything. And then we can provide, I think you already have the copy of Merrill's final sign-off that was dated Friday.
It's supposed to be seven.
Just
give
them
one package.
Seven
everything.
Yep.
One package.
No, that was the old one.
Yeah. No, it was the one from Friday. You just gave it to us on Friday, so it's still pretty quick turnaround.
So we need
I think
a
we submitted original copies of this homeowner report.
I have to read my oldest
great work.
Okay.
Thanks,
Scott. Do we need a vote on that?
I think
continue until next
yes.
week? We need a vote to continue that till next week?
Usually you don't have to vote to continue.
Right. Okay. So we'll have copies of the plan. So I'll make the motion that we...
June
20th at
7:30.
7:30
it is.
I'll be here.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll
be here.
Thank you,
guys.
So we have the motion?
Yes, the motion is on the table. I'll second it.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
I'm retired. That's the whole thing.
Okay, I think we just have a couple other items to go through, make sure we sign these things in the folder for extension permits.
Yeah, we signed those already.
Okay.
Yeah, they were saying that. We signed office and foreign notes.
I think that's everything.
Merrill's
we should
review
have, yeah, it's in the folder.
And a copy of the appeal. And I think that's
so,
it,
so we'll have to come in and get that material and look it over by next week.
Email is the best.
Yeah.
Email is the best way to
do.
Yeah.
You want a copy.
Okay.
Do you need a copy?
You can send email to me.
Okay.
How many pages are we going to have, Mary?
Yeah.
How many pages on the email are you going to have? Because that's... five or six of what I was looking at tonight, plus whatever they put coming. We're looking at about 8 or 10 page email.
I will be sending them separately. I will send a Merrill's review in the draft permit. If you guys want to read the planning board draft form to get it.
What I'm really getting at is what my wife tells me. Damn it, you're going to have to buy the ink when you keep getting this much stuff sent to you.
That's why I don't print it. I don't print it at all. I flip through and read it, and I can save it.
I print it out for whoever wants it, and I can
I print everything out and file it. Carry it with me.
I'll just take it by email. He'll take it by email too.
I like to sit down and save the writing. I don't like reading all that.
I'm a speed reader, skim through it. That's what I do all day. You know, fly through our. It saves paper. It saves things. It saves.
Yeah, we don't need to use all that ink.
I have a problem.
You do.
With my GMC.
Oh.
Key not matching. In other words, it shuts itself down on its automatic anti-theft. And, I've got their thing. If I sit there and go through the
10-minute relearn.
Yeah, it'll come back. It doesn't do it all the time, but it does it every time you really want it.
Yeah, it sounds like you've got the probably heater that will use it.
That's it for tonight. Can we have a motion to close?
Motion to close.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.